Hi, I'm Josh with Hunter Engineering Company. Today we're going to be going over a quick calibration check and how to recalibrate your Hunter Forcematch balancer. The very first thing we need to do, there's a weight that's on the back side of the balancer that we're going to need to check the calibration and also to perform the calibration. Come back here, I'll show you where the weight is. On the back side of the machine from the monitor, just follow your post down and you have your calibration weight screwed into the back of the balancer. Go ahead and unscrew your weight. And then we'll come around to the front. All right, so from your start screen, it looks like you have three options. Identify, balance, and then to drop down your green arrows and your soft keys. There's actually one more option that's not so easy to identify. If we press start from our start screen right here, we're gonna go into a calibration check. All we're doing is following the pictures here and doing exactly what it says. So we're gonna be putting our calibration weight, the same weight that we use on the back side of the monitor post, we're going to screw it into the left side of the hub face and press start. It doesn't matter if it's at 12 o'clock or any position whatsoever. It just matters which side of the hub face you put it on. Go ahead and lower your hood. Press start. So all we're doing is checking the calibration of the machine. So it's first spinning. It's a 4-ounce weight, so when we should finish the calibration check, it should be able to show us approximately a 4-ounce weight on the left side and approximately zero on the right side. So it says calibration ready, which means it passes its calibration. If it would fail calibration, it would then say calibration required. All right, so let's check and see what our weights are. Like I said, we have the weight on the left side, so we should be showing somewhere around 4 here and somewhere around 0 here. So we'll hit K1 for show weights, 4.25 and 0.05. Very, very, very good. All right, so this arrow right here is another important thing we want to check. This doesn't have anything to do with weight. It all has to do with placement, so that 12 o'clock position. It's a big reason why guys may chase weights. If the balancer isn't coming back up and actually stopping at 12 o'clock, maybe you're going to be chasing weights. We want to prevent that from happening. So let's roll this up to the 12 o'clock position. Our laser comes on. You can see our laser here on our weight. Splits right down the middle of our weight here. And also our arrow turns green on the top. So we know our 12 o'clock position is also correct as well. So we know we're good to go here. Everything checks out. We're ready to go ahead and start doing our balancing now. My personal recommendation, check calibration, say once a day if you wanted to, maybe once a week. It depends on how often you use your balancer. But it's something that's very easy to do. It takes about 45 seconds to be able to check your weight, your balancer calibration. So I highly recommend that you guys do it. A couple things that could prevent you from getting good numbers. You could have weights up underneath here. So if weights kind of start building up down here, the balancer could actually rock a little bit. If it's not on stable ground, you could actually get some weird numbers. Also, if say you have a really, really large crack. This one's just to the side of where the balancer actually sits. But maybe if it's not on a level surface and it's kind of rocking, you could also get some weird numbers. So that's going to be it for how to be able to check calibration of your machine.